Hello and welcome to the fourth exercise in the Practicing Functional JavaScript series. This one is called Resistor Color Duo, and it's kind of a follow-up to the last exercise, Resistor Color. So let's get to it. So if you want to build something using a Raspberry Pi, you'll probably use resistors. For this exercise, you need to know two things about them. Each resistor has a resistance value, and resistors are small, so small in fact that if you printed the resistance value on them, it would be hard to read. So to get around this problem, manufacturers print color-coded bands onto the resistors to denote their resistance value. And each band has a position and a numeric value. So for example, if they printed a brown band, it would have a value of 1, followed by a green band with a value of 5, it would translate to the number 15. So in this exercise, we're going to create a helpful program so that we don't have to remember the values of the bands. And the program will take color names as input, and then it will output a two-digit number, even if the input is more than two colors. So these are the same colors as the last exercise. So black would correspond to 0, brown to 1, and so on, all the way up to white, which would be 9. And then here are a couple examples. Brown-green should return 15, and brown-green-violet should also return 15, ignoring violet. All right, so I think that's all we need to get started. I'll open the file that we'll use to solve the problem in right here, and our tests on the right. Then I'll run the tests. And they are failing, as expected. So let's go through this. So this is, I think, a little bit more complicated than resistor color. So before we actually code out the solution, I'd like to step by step look at the data transformations. So I'll start just with the function signature. And we can kind of use our test over here. To see an example of the input and the output of this value function. So we'll say that value is a function that maps, it maps an array of strings. So this is how I'll represent an array of strings. An array with a string in it means it's an array of string values. And as for the output, we'll just get a number. So that's our goal. But in order to get there, we have to do some data transformations. So I'm kind of going to go through those first in a few steps. So the first thing we need to do, since we want to get a number from this array of strings, so the first thing we have to do is we have to map these string values in the array to their corresponding number value. So in order to do that, we can just represent that as map array of strings to an array of numbers. So that can be the first step. And then after we have an array of numbers, the next thing that we'll need to do is to join those numbers into a single number. So let's just, we can just call that join. So we'll say as input for this step, we'll say number. And then as the output, an array of numbers, and the output would be, so if they're being joined, it will be a string. So it should be a string, and we'll check this. All right, so now that we have a string, we need that string to ultimately be a number. If we look back really quick, there is a kind of edge case where we want to ignore if there's more than one or more than two digits. So for example, brown, green, violet. And so in order to ignore that, I think we can just slice to just get the first two characters of the string. So this will still be a string to a string, but this is just to remember that this is an important step. And then the last step is where we can parse the string and get a number. All right, so those, I think, are the main steps that we need, and I'm just going to use that for reference since this is a little bit more complicated and just so we can keep track of where we are. All right, so let's start with step one. I'm actually just going to get rid of these comments because they're kind of unnecessary. And we can get rid of that error. And so let's start with the first step. So we're going to map an array of strings to an array of numbers. And so let's actually get the array of strings. We can cheat and go to resistor color, which we just did. And I'll just copy the array right here so we don't have to type it out. All right, so we have an array of strings. And then we will take, so this is actually receiving an array. So let's call it color values. This is the parameter for the function. And let's return, since we're just focused on the first step right now, let's return color values. Let's return the color values mapped for each color value. We will look up the index from the array, index of color value. And that, forgot one thing. So we need the anonymous function in here. So to define the parameter, color value. And yeah, that should be what we need to get to the first step. And we can kind of see that right here. We're no longer getting undefined, and we're getting what we expected, an array of numbers for the first step. So I can put a check mark right here. Let's see if this will work. All right, so check. So we've done the first one. All right, so let's go on to the next step. So now we just want to join this array of numbers into a string. So that should be pretty straightforward. I think we can just join on an empty string. Let's see. Yep. So now we have the string 10 that we've joined, and we can mark this transformation off. And why is my emoji not working? Okay, there. And then the next step is to slice, but I'll actually wait on this one just to see it fail for I think it's the last test case right here. Let's see this one fail. But for now, let's just go ahead and convert it to a number at the end. So there's different ways to parse a string, but I'm just going to use the number constructor. So I'll wrap this call right here in the call to number constructor. That should be all we need to do to get a number. And yeah, that's it. So this test is passing, and we can go ahead and uncomment the other, or enable the other tests to see if they're all passing. All right, blue and gray, we're getting 68. And yellow and violet, we're getting 47. And orange should give us 33. All right, so the last one, this is the one that we would expect to fail. Since orange is 0, 1, 2, 3. So we're expecting 5, 1, but I think we'll get 5, 1, 3. So let's see if that will fail with that error. Yep, so we're getting 5, 1, 3. So in order to fix this, let's go back. I forgot to check this off, but let's go back to step 3. And the part that we forgot, we want to slice the first two characters in the string. So after joining, I'm going to slice, and from the zero index to the second index exclusive, that so it doesn't include it. And so this should be what we need, but that failed. So let's see, what did we miss here? What are we getting? Oh, it's a typo, slice. Okay, there we go. All right, so now all our tests are passing. We've solved the problem. And our next step is to refactor this to a more functional solution, and we'll use Ramda for that.
Thank you for watching Resistor Color Duo Part 1, and be sure to check out Part 2.